Well, on my channel, some of my most viewed videos are RV reviews. I've been doing them for several years now, before the pandemic, during the pandemic, and after the pandemic. And now, I would definitely say that RV sales have slowed very dramatically, or incrementally, and now very much at a normal slash lower sales point. I don't want to use the word crash, and I don't want to pump fear and be dramatic or be hurtful to RV salespeople or people in the RV industry or people who just bought an RV, because there's no value in that, okay? I don't need to really make clickbait. I don't need to do it. But I will say now, from my experience, okay, of doing thousands of RV review videos, being on the dealership myself doing them, a variety of different dealerships, and in those different time periods in the past few years, I could say that inventory is way up, and sales are down, and prices are still higher though. Prices have, in 2023, especially now as we approach into the second half, I have seen pricing start to come down, but nowhere near pre-pandemic, and it probably, I don't know if it'll ever go back there, because even if you had regular 2-3% inflation, that means prices on everything goes up 2-3%. That's average inflation throughout history. So, you know, a price correction, though, in RVs is more probably of a reality than homes, okay? Because a standard house or condo is an appreciating asset, meaning over time it has more value to more people in society to have this fixed structure on land that you own and you can raise your family in it, versus a vehicle, an RV, which is more of a recreational vacation or lifestyle. And yes, few people will try to live in it, but overall, it's a vehicle, and long-term, it's going to go down in value. And the masses, most people in society, don't look at that as functional asset or functional use in their everyday life. Again, most people want to live in a house or a condo or something like that. So, you know, so the RV industry is faced with a little bit of a dilemma. One is, you know, it's... you had your time to feast, okay? Now it's going to be a little bit of famine, okay? It's going to be a little bit of leaner times. And you do have an asset that is more of a liability, not, you know, it's a depreciating asset, an RV versus appreciating asset. So now that's back in line of pre-pandemic. Like during the pandemic, when there was no supply chain, there was no more production, and there was no international travel, you had high demand, low inventory, prices, and people who normally, that's the key thing, people that normally wouldn't even consider RVs were looking at them because they had no choice. That was like the only way you could really travel, and it made sense during pandemic times, right? And so now all those things have changed around, okay? And you have this slowdown, and you'll really see a price correction as we get into 2024, right? Because you're probably going to have RV dealerships are going to have a lot of extra inventory from 2023. See, 2022, they were still moving units. Now, 2023, they're not moving units, not at a regular pace. They're a lot slower. And, you know, so they're going to have a lot of inventory left over from this year going into 2024. And then you also have a lot of people that bought RVs during the pandemic, and they're putting their used units on the market for resale or going to dealerships and selling them for pennies on the dollar. So you have all this inventory, because again, the average person only keeps their first RV for 3 years or less. So, you know, if the pandemic was 2020, 2021, now in this year and the next 2 years, you're going to have a lot of used units back on the market. So you're going to have a little bit of a glut of inventory in 2024. And obviously, if everything would kind of continue to normalize in society, you'll probably have some more price correction. And the trend of RVing, that's also over. So that's also another momentum bust. So there's always going to be people that RV. There's going to be few in society that full-time RV with no home base. But again, 90% of society doesn't want an RV. 90% of society doesn't want to live in an RV. So you're never going to appeal to the masses, okay, at a mass scale. You know, the pandemic was a mass exception for a short period of time. So what would I say? Are you going to get this great deal in an RV? No. Why? Because one is there's still a level of value. People, there's still some people that want them. And don't forget, they don't produce hundreds of thousands of RVs, especially when you talk about like motorhomes and things like that, right? If you're talking about travel trailers and things like that, small, cheap ones, they mass produce them, but, you know, they're just not going, you know, they're already priced at, you know, the cheaper ones, 20, 30,000. So, you know, a decent RV in decent condition is not going to be under 10,000 or 15,000. And a motorhome is still a vehicle, so it still has use to drive. So, and they don't produce as many motorhomes as they do trailers. So, you know, you're going to see some more prices probably come down. You have more negotiating power at the RV dealership. But, you know, you're not going to get a brand new Class B motorhome that was listed at $100,000 for $30,000. You know, and that's a little bit of the problem of the person always trying to get this magical deal. You know, it's like when prices crash, they don't go buying them, or when prices are low, they want everything 90% off, and it doesn't happen. So, you know, you're not going to get that, but, you know, you'll probably could go to an RV dealership and negotiate definitely 10% to 30% off, probably asking price depending. But again, they're still not that interested in that heavy of discount for units that are newer, because they, you know, they're going to keep them on the lot longer. So, you know, again, this video is to make the statement of my experience, past, present, currently, and looking forward, is it's just the way it is. Things have slowed down, inventory's higher, prices have come down, probably going to come down a little bit more. But, you know, you're always faced with time, right? Like, as an example, if you're retired or if you've saved up money and you have money to do something, you can put it off in hopes to possibly get it at a lower price, but now you're going to waste time. 6 months, a year, 2 years out of your life with no guarantee that prices will be different from them. And that's always the question, like, when do you buy a house? When do you get married? When do you do this? You know, you can put it off, and sometimes you should, for a better time, a better situation. But when you put something off, you spend time out of your life that you'll never get back. And there is some level of aspect that responsibly, when you live below your means, when you've done the research, when you've tried to do everything right, and you took your time with things, you know, you want to seize the moment, because the average human life is 80 years old. The first 20 years of your life, you know, you're kind of young in adolescence. And, you know, probably not until you're 30 or 40 do you have enough wherewithal to make big purchases like this. And a lot of people who do purchase these things are retired, so they've already worked and they're at a certain level. So they're not looking at it always as, oh, I can wait and get another 20% off, maybe. They're looking at it as, you know, I'm healthy now at 60, 65, 70. I don't want to wait 2 years, even if prices would be even cheaper. So, you know, and, you know, there's certain people that look for $100,000 vans. They make $30,000 a year. You shouldn't even be looking at $100,000 worth of van, you know, so you got to be honest with yourself there too. So either way, I hope this video helped you, give you some insight from my experience. If it did, click the thumbs up, share the video, click the super thanks. Thank you to my members. Click the join button if you want to be a member, and I'll see you in the next one.